At the height of the flood, the Colorado River discharged through the crevasse more than 75,000 cubic feet per second, while the Salton Sea, into which this immense volume of water was poured, rose at the rate of 7 inches per day over an area of 400 square miles. The most dangerous and alarming feature of the situation was the cutting back of the torrents as they rushed down the delta slope toward the Salton Sea. The fine silt of which the soil was composed washed out like sugar, and wherever there happened to be a strong current, the flow soon produced a rapid. The rapid then became a cascade. The cascade grew into a fall, and the fall finally developed into a roaring cataract, which cut back upstream at the rate of 4,000 feet per day, and leaving below it a deep gorge with almost perpendicular walls. Some of the gorges were 50 to 80 feet deep and more than 1,000 feet across. The effect of this flood, in a geological way, was of extraordinary interest and very spectacular. In 9 months, during 1905 and 1906, the runaway waters of the Colorado River had eroded from the New and Alamo River channels and carried down into the Salton Sea a volume almost four times as great as that of the entire Panama Canal. The combined length of the channels cut out was almost 43 miles, the average width being 1,000 feet and the depth 50 feet. To this total of 420 million cubic yards must be added about 10% for side canyons, surface erosion, etc. Very rarely, if ever, has it been possible to see a geological agent effect in a few months a change which usually requires centuries.